Flighted and going big. Six Penneth. Top shot from Inzamam. Floated up there from Murali saying, hit me if you dare. Inzamam did.
Well, Inzamam doing the obvious thing, using his feet, getting to the pitch of the ball and hitting it over the top for maximum.
For that man. And he's got it through for four. Pushback Amara made a goodish effort, seemed to get across to the ball, but it escaped him.
Well, this is the point, you know, when you use your feet against Murali, you know, he tries and changes line and length, and that's where the batsmen have to really, you know, pounce on the opportunities and start hitting.
There it is, up in the slot again, and he's gone for another one. This time it's four, but very cleanly hit nevertheless. So accepting the challenge, 105 for three.
Oh, nicely played. This is a wonderful hit. Inzamam ul Haq adjusting quickly and playing through the line towards the mid-on region.
That was wonderfully well played by Inzamam ul Haq. Shaminder Vaz, not too short, just a trifle, but Inzamam so powerful on the back foot. Just see once again that full face of the bat which Ramiz had been talking about. That's what makes him less vulnerable, and just hitting it past mid-on, between the bowler and the mid-on. There's plenty of space around that area. It's very firmly hit. Powering at that.
This is again stroked nicely. Not hitting it too hard. Pushpa Kumara struggling to get to the ball. Just come back for the third, and yes, they are. So again, a very good timing on the back foot, this time through mid-wicket by Inzamam ul Haq. This single will give him his 4,000 run in Test match career. Wonderful analysis. And 3999 will now be 4000. Very good career record as a result of that one run. He has overtaken Hanif Muhammad, Majid Khan, and now becomes the fifth Pakistani to get to that 4,000 mark.
Oh, hello, he's dug that one in short. There's two men back there, and having to club it down almost like a tennis serve. That ball was so high, it took Inzamam, I think, a little by surprise. Just a loosener from Wickramasinghe. This one getting through just for the single. Nice shot, no need to run for that. Four more.
That was a great shot by Inzamam. Man in form. A little bit short. Coming in, and off the back foot he goes. Beautifully played through the gap, and real power behind that one.
In the air.
Oh, that's beautifully struck. Getting the momentum. That was hit very, very hard.
End of the over. Pakistan 198 for five. Beautifully played. Even though it'll get him just a single, or probably come back for the second. But played with a lot of authority. And very good timing once again. Lazily moving into the stroke. He's an 85 with just 151 deliveries.
Oh, beautiful stroke. Hit with immense power, straight back. And you can't do a lot when Inzamam is striking the ball the manner in which he has done.
Enough of Ramiz.
Oh, again, beautifully played.
It was too good a shot for a single.
The good thing about in Zamam's batting is when he's playing against the spin, is making sure that he stretches it front, bat, forward, gets to the pitch of the delivery.
Well, this is what Zamam has been doing so very well in this innings. Seeing that wide gap on the offside, rocking back, giving himself room and just crashing it through that area. A superb shot. His timing has been absolutely impeccable.
Everyone coming up, mid off, mid on, coming inside. In circle, I was going to say. So Zamam on 99, last ball of the over. And he just works it wide of mid off for his 100. This will be his 900 in Test cricket. Zamam goes to 100 not out. A fine hand following his 86 in the first innings, 13 fours and a six, 180 balls, and doing the job for Pakistan.
Crashed through the offside.
Nice stroke from Zamam.
It's the fielder at the point area, but he didn't have any chance because it was beautifully timed.
Yes, definitely. It's been the feature of Zamam's batting all day long. He's been eyeing the ball very well. He's sighting the ball and he gets into the position very early and just stands tall and hit through the line. It's a beautiful shot.
Running with the shot and easily done in the end. Sana Jaswari just a little late to react. He wasn't expecting Zamam to go for that one. Cutting down beautifully. Whew, that went like a rocket.
Great stroke from Zamam. Gave it a real thumb. And the fielder there, they never had the chance to stop this one. Again, Wickramasinghe giving room to the player who's playing at 122. But all the time to hit this ball. Gave it a real thump in Zamam.
Trying to give it the full whack. He's got an inside edge. And still would get him four runs. So Zamam ul Haq really turning on the screws here. 132 not out.
Certainly dominating the bowling in Zamam.
He's just looking for the width, Ramiz. He's just going for everything which is wide, short or fuller. He's just putting the bat on everything. You see again, it was pitched outside the leg stump. All Zamam had to do was put the bat on the ball. Got four runs for it. It'd be interesting to see what the Pakistanis have in their mind when they want to declare.
Smash through the point. Pushpa Kumara doing rather well covering the area quite quickly because that ball was really traveling.
Going over the top, mid off coming to catch it. Wickramasinghe taking the catch. Well, a long off and long on in, so I'm not quite sure where Zamam was trying to hit this one. And what a sad end, really. 138, great innings from him. And he may have been trying to hit it more over extra cover, which would have taken quite a lot better execution. So Zamam goes, caught it long off by Wickramasinghe.
So that's a big wicket for Sri Lanka to get rid of Zamam. See the back of him, Zamam. Maybe a slight lapse of concentration due to that confrontation, but holding it out to Wickramasinghe. And a great innings from Zamam coming to an end. Pakistan, 319 for 7. 320, beg your pardon, for 7. And there you are, fine innings in